Good morning. Welcome to church right here in the Bell Davis heartland. It's so good to be here this morning, jumping and singing. Yeah. Praising our God. His name is Jesus. Jesus. Move around. Greet as many people as you can in the name of Jesus right here in Spires Life Church this morning. Moving all around. Greeting. Please be seated, church. Unstoppable God. Nothing going to stop him. Nothing going to stop him and his kingdom. Please be seated. Well, I've got this handheld microphone here and this other one's working fine. So that means I'm going to talk to someone else who's going to use this microphone. Oh, you got your own. Oh, Steve, come and get this one. Mind that for me, would you, mate?
It's only good when the sound man turns it on.
Oh, no. There you go. There we go. Helen, look, we've got a whole pack of stuff over here.
I did fall down. Did that have something to do with me jumping around?
Yeah. What's the, like, yellow, red, blue in that box?
They're bocce balls.
They're bocce?
Yeah.
I think there's going to be bocce at the picnic under the big tree. Yeah? And what else you got there?
And we've got some cricket.
Yeah.
Bats,
yep.
I'm sure we'll have some balls on the day.
Yeah, they will, yeah.
And a frisbee.
And a frisbee,
and yeah. I've heard a rumour of some other, like, old-fashioned type games, like egg and spoon
race. Three-legged race.
Three-legged
race. Here we go.
Maybe not in these shoes, though,
Gordon. We would be a lot of fun in those shoes. Yeah.
I think Buffington might have an issue with a broken ankle.
Yeah, he's not even paying attention.
See, you know, I try to be funny.
No, you've got him now. He's in the palm of your hand now. Yeah, you know, you've got him. She's got him. Do you want to look at him? No, don't do that to him.
Look back. I'm really
nervous. Now, this picnic. Now, some people said to me, oh, this picnic, I'm going to go out and I'm going to go to Red Rooster, buy a chicken and chips.
No, don't do that.
Don't do that. What should they do?
They should grab their form.
Like this?
Like this one. This one here. See this form? Everybody grab the form. It should be next to you or underneath you. Hopefully it's not underneath you because you'll need to fill it in. Okay, there's heaps of options there that we have been going back and forth about for about 2 weeks. My awesome team and I. Is it my team? It's our team.
Our team, yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So we've made it as easy as possible for you. Like, as a mum, I'm like, goodness me, picnic. Oh, that's a lot of work. But we've made it as easy as possible for you. So all you have to do for each member of your family, all you have to do is tick the options that they would like. So grab a form for each person. There's some adult options, and there's some kid options, or kid-friendly options. And we're certainly catering for any allergies or special requests that you might have. By special requests, we mean you really hate something and you really don't want it in your picnic.
And it'll give you a rash, so don't have that.
Yeah, no. So we've made it as easy as possible. Put your name, your email, your phone number on there, fill it in, and then go pay at the
information desk. Now, I'm going to tell a little bit more about that after you've vacated and your husband knows that your ankles are good because you haven't tripped on the shoes, right?
They're pretty, though.
Thank you for sharing with us. Okay. Give Helen a big round of applause. That's fantastic. Bocce. Mr. Mark Buckle. Is Mr. Mark Buckle in the house? Where's Mr. Mark Buckle? Please stand, Mr. Mark Buckle. For those who don't know, that's Mr. Mark Buckle. By the way, he's the author. You can be seated now. They know who you are now. He's the author of that clip we saw before, too, breaking the bottle of champagne against the big tree, which it's not going to go down either. And he's the guy that we work in the crowd after this service, in the cafe and out the back with these to get you to sign up, pay up, and be part of the picnic. And I just need to say on that, Diamond Tree Studio are sponsoring us, all right? And it's always good to get sponsorship, isn't it? So when you pay, you'll actually be paying into the Diamond Tree Studios account. And you think, why are they getting the money? Well, because they're sponsoring it. They're putting it on. So Look out for Mr. Mark Buckle and say, I would like a picnic basket, and I'm going to tick the relevant box to get what the thing is best suits me and my family. Is that cool?
Yep.
Yes, it is. Just a couple of other things I found on seats. I don't know if you've found them on yours, Camp Sunshine. Yep, and this was on mine. Now, there's a whole box of these in at the information desk. These are invitations to be put in letterboxes, and if you still would like to do that, you know, I know it's going to be 30-something today and 38 tomorrow, but by next week, and I say, oh, some people are happy, summer is coming. Other people say, well, it's on a cool day, I'll do some letterbox drop. Would you do that? And just before we get into the message, I sent out an email on Friday about a 12-year-old boy who was diagnosed with a brain tumor and had the surgery on Friday, a real protracted thing, like about a 14-hour procedure. And just to give you an update, because I didn't have access yesterday to the church database, I did put it on Facebook, for those of you who are on Facebook. Kona is awake, this is Friday. Kona is awake, talking, and can move both arms and legs. That's good, yeah? That's good, because they're the vital signs. But this amazing boy has come out of his first op. Thank you for calls, prayers, and help. Please continue to pray for him and his family and all involved with his care. And I'll keep you posted on that during the week via the church database. Cool? Yeah? Yeah, that's good. Father in heaven, thank you that you are the God of healing. You bring healing. You're our divine physician. You're the one that we look to for healing. And this morning, Father, we give you our thanks and our praise. And if someone else is dealing with the giant of poor health, this morning we pray against that giant in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Giants and grasshoppers. Yeah, we talked about that last week. And I want to start off by talking about giants and grasshoppers. Moses sent 12 spies into what would be the promised land to bring back a report, not to see whether or not we should take the promised land. If it's the promised land and promised by God, it's the promised land, we're going to have the promised land. Unstoppable God. He sent the 12 spies in to bring back a report, not to see if we should, but see how we should. 10 of those spies came back and they brought back a negative report. They said, we saw the biggest grapes you've ever seen. It took 2 men to carry them. And they said, of course, they're giants. Big grapes, big men. They're giants, we grasshoppers. They weren't grasshoppers any more than you're a grasshopper. And the people in the land weren't giants either. They're just people. But see, what we do when an issue becomes big to us, we often will build it up and say, I just can't do it. That's going to take me out. It's a giant of an issue to me. And so I've titled this series Dealing with Giants. And the design of this series is to show how all of us can overcome the giants that we encounter in our difficult circumstances. And so two big questions today. Number one, how we're going to fight those giants. And number two, why we should fight them at all anyway. So how are we going to fight those giants? Well, first of all, the very first thing, any issue in life, giants or not, whatever the issue might be, you need to take up the fight, not in your own firepower, but in the name of the Lord Almighty. Lord Almighty. Now, the reason I use this term Lord Almighty is because we do have a propensity, all of us, to kind of take on the fight in our own firepower. We go, yeah, I think I can sort this, and I'm fired up enough to take it on. When Jesus has far better firepower than any of you have, or than I have. And so I think about how we might do it with our human firepower, and this is what I've seen, and I'm guilty of this, and you probably all are too. We want to come up with human arguments and human reactions. And when we're confronted with a giant, whatever it might be, we start to feel sorry for ourselves. Oh, woe is me. Oh, you don't know the things that I've been through. Oh. And then we start blaming others. If only they hadn't have done that, and then I wouldn't be in this place. And sometimes we get all physical about it and say, if you do that to me again, I'll take you out, man. I mean, try to take me on, you know. And sometimes we even go legal firepower instead of God's power. Yeah. And we do all this. And so I've used the title for God, the Lord Almighty. I've used this because that's the title that David used when confronting the giant Goliath. He said, I'm not coming against you with swords. I'm coming against you in the name of the Lord Almighty. And I just want to tell you something about this. You'll note how that's spelt. Lord is spelt in all capitals, capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D. And in case you hadn't figured this out yet, in your Old Testament, wherever you get Lord spelt in all capitals, That's a rendition of the Hebrew word Yahweh, where it's capital L and little O-R-D, that's Adonai usually. This is, and the Hebrew word Yahweh essentially means I am. And you know the story about Moses at the burning bush. And God says, I want you to lead my people out of Egypt to the promised land, and I want you to tell Pharaoh, let my people go. Moses, talking to the burning bush, good question, he said, who shall I say send me? And God came up with a classic answer. He said, tell them, I am who I am. And I could see Moses going, yeah, right. It's interesting because the Hebrew name Yahweh is essentially the verb to be I am. God was saying, my name is Yahweh. And I think about that because Jesus arrives on planet Earth and he starts to use this all the time. I am the Good Shepherd. I am the light of the world. And Jesus says, before Abraham was, I am. And Jesus used all of those. I am the bread of life. And Jesus is saying, I am. Jesus is the great I am. And so if you want to understand and see who the Lord Almighty is, capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, it's Jesus. This is Jesus. Jesus shows up saying, I am the Lord Almighty. So I don't know what giants you are confronted with today, but whatever they are, you need to back away from using your own firepower, and you need to fight these in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And you say, well, what kind of giants are you talking about, Gordon? Well, the kind that you have all the time and I have all the time, financial issues. For some of you, that's a bigger giant than for others right now. Relational issues. And if you're honest, from time to time, you're just going to have those. Because they don't. Not everyone agrees with you all the time, do they? In your house even, yeah? And you can't get it why they don't. It becomes a giant. If only she would get it. And she goes, if only he would get it. And she's right, yeah? Busy issues, there's another one. Family issues are much like the relational ones, yeah? Vocational issues, you know, work. I can't get a job, doesn't pay enough anyway. Business issues, I'm starting a business, and no one seems to understand why I'm starting a business. Study issues, students. We come to the end of the year, teachers. Study issues. Ministry issues. Yeah? We're called for volunteers. So well, I volunteer my guts out, no one appreciates it. Ministry issues. Health issues. And God said to me, say it again, health issues. And God said to me, say it again, health issues. Whatever the giants are that are confronting you, leave your own human firepower behind and look to the Lord Almighty. His name is Jesus. Zechariah chapter 4, verses 6 to 7, classic scripture here. And let me give you the background of this. The people of Judah, Jerusalem, had been taken off into captivity to Babylon, and under the ministry of Nehemiah and Ezra and Zerubbabel and Haggai and Zechariah, they returned to rebuild the wall. You know, Nehemiah rebuilt the wall, and under these other characters to rebuild the temple. And they're going, this too many hurdles, too many obstacles, too many giants, too many mountains to rebuild the temple. And so Zechariah gets the word from the Lord. And so he said to me, this is the word of the capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, Lord, to Zerubbabel. Not by might nor by power, but by spirit, says the capital L, O, Lord Almighty. It's the same Lord Almighty. Well, what are you, mighty mountain? Giants can appear as mountains. Before Zerubbabel, you will become level ground. And then he will bring out the capstone to shouts of God bless it, God bless it. So the giants are there, the mountains there, and the giant in Zechariah's day, the mountain in Zechariah's day, was all the things that stood in the way of rebuilding the temple. And God said through the prophet, you will overcome these giants. Not by your own might, not by your own strength, not by your own smart plans, but by the power of the Spirit of God, the Lord Almighty. And the Lord Jesus Christ and his Holy Spirit, that's what we're looking to. And this is a matter of trust for you whenever those giants are confronting you, because you go, oh, I don't want to wait for the Lord. And as soon as he showed up, I want to get on and do it myself. And the Lord tells us that when we trust him to let his spirit deal with the giants in our lives. Having said that, you're going to have to do what he tells you to do. You won't just be sitting on your backside and not doing anything, but you've got to do what he tells you, not what you might want to do off the first mark. And by his spirit, he will level mountains that stand in your way. He will bring the giant down. He'll bring the giant down. David took on Goliath in the name of the Lord Almighty, and he brought the giant. 1 Samuel 17:49, of the giant, it says, he fell face down on the ground. He's not getting up again. In the name of the Lord Almighty. David brought down the giant in the name of the Lord Almighty. And so whatever giants are confronting you, and I've mentioned them already, let me do them again. Relational issues, yeah. Yeah, husbands and wives, or anyone else for that matter. Busy issues, family issues, vocational issues, study issues, students, yeah, it's a big giant right now. Business issues, ministry issues, emotional issues, health issues, and health issues. And sometimes these things can seem to be such huge giants, we're tempted to attack them on a worldly basis. And I want to remind you that they're all spiritual issues. You go, no, they're not, Gordon, they're just practical. No, they're spiritual issues. And if you as a believer are a believer, then you no longer fight the battles against these giants as the world does. Listen to this, Ephesians 6:12. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realm. So you may think, oh, no, but a person has upset me. And I want to take on that person because they're giving me grief. And it's even worse when you live with that person. You know, they're giving me grief. But see, you're probably giving them grief. That's not the issue. These are spiritual issues, spiritual force of evil that are working through you. Your struggle is not against flesh and blood. It's against the forces of darkness and evil. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. For though we live in the world, chapter 10, verse 3 to 5, for though we live in the world, we do not wage war as the world does. The weapons we fight with are not the weapons of the world, as they're supposed to be. On the contrary, they have divine power to demolish strongholds. We demolish arguments and every pretension that sets itself up against the knowledge of God, and we take captive every thought to what? Make it obedient to Christ. We operate by prayer and we operate by trust in the Lord Almighty. His name is Jesus. Psalm 33, verses 16 and 19. No king is saved by the size of his army. No warrior escapes by his great strength. A horse is a vain hope for deliverance. Despite all its great strength, it cannot save. But the eyes of the Lord are on those who fear him, on those whose hope is in his unfailing love, to deliver them from death and keep them alive in famine, on his unfailing love. Proverbs 21, verse 30, 31. There is no wisdom, no insight, no plan that can succeed against who? All capitals. It's Yahweh. It's Jesus. The horse is made ready for the day of battle, but victory rests with the... It's with Yahweh, the Lord. One more for you. Psalm 20, verse 7. Some trust in chariots, some in horses, but we trust in the name of who? Yahweh, the Lord our God. Victory by military might or by the Lord. I just want to tell you this story. I mentioned to you last week about our retaining wall up near the shed, and how when the Caccione spatial developments spires came through, they changed the levels with the road, and suddenly we were that much lower. And we, how are we going to deal with this? So I rang them, and they go, it's not our problem. And some of our guys here, they're no longer here, so I can speak quite clearly about this, they go, take the Carcionis to court. Now, you'd have to be a joker to even suggest that, really, but these guys weren't joking. You gutless wonder, Gordon, take them to court. They're probably the richest men in WA. They own half of Baldivis, yeah? So I thought, that's not smart at all, and I'm thinking about these scriptures, you know? I'm thinking I'm going to go to the church and raise about $5,000 or whatever it was to build the wall, and I did that, probably came in less than that. We all gave the money. and got the wall up there. And since then, I've been to Spatial Developments, which is the Carcioni brothers, they've given us $1,500 for our Christmas program we put on outdoor here. They gave us another $1,500 for an outdoor movie we did out the front a few years ago. They gave us another $1,500 for another Christmas we did, and I rang them up during the week. This is what I want to tell you. All right, Diamond Tree Studios sponsoring our picnic. Carcioni's are sponsoring our Camp Sunshine to the tune of another $1,500. Come on! That's $6,000, so we're in front, and they're still friends. Victory by military might or by the Lord? Victory by worldly aggression and methods or by the Lord? God's people choose wisely which battles they will fight and how they will fight those battles. The weapons for God's people are things like truth and faith and a right relationship with God, peace, salvation, prayer, the word of God, and trying to get on with people. Well, we can. Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, you know, just before he was crucified, was arrested by the temple guards. And he had three of his disciples there with him. And Peter reacted like most of us probably would when that sort of stuff goes down on that kind of an occasion. He took out his sword, and the first soldier that came near him, he chopped his ear off. And Jesus said, we don't do that. We don't go around using swords and chopping ears off. And Jesus bent down and picked up that ear and he put it back on and healed it. Often what we want to do, we want to hurt people, and Jesus gives us a model. He said, be people of healing rather than of hurt. I think one of the giants that many people in this building right now face are issues to do with health, and Jesus says, I didn't come to hurt, I came to heal. Dealing with giants, it's a call to healing. So if you're out of whack with someone in relationship, because that can be a giant, you need to work on healing. What we want to do when someone hurts is we want to hurt them back. And I'll teach you a lesson. How will they ever learn that they've just hurt me if I don't hurt them back? Well, they won't. You know what they'll do when you hurt them back? They'll hurt you back a bit harder. And then what you're going to do, you're going to try and hurt them back a bit harder. And it's a table tennis match that never stops. I love table tennis. It'll stop when I'm playing. You'll either beat me or I'll beat you. Right? But with this kind of game, it just won't stop. And so Jesus is on about healing rather than on about hurting. So why do we fight giants anyway? Well, of course, we fight that to get the relational issues sorted out, we think, you know. We do that to get the vocational issues sorted out. We fight the giant to get the whatever the issues are sorted out. So fair enough, those giants are there and we need to deal with those. But over and above all of that, we fight the giants in the name of the Lord Almighty. Listen to this, should be on your screen. So that the world will know that God is here in our midst. Amen. Is that an amen? I saw an amen come up on my screen there. Thank you for that. And so Goliath, the Philistine hero and the giant that David fought, had been taunting and ridiculing God and God's people. And that's the primary reason David took him on. And David speaking, 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 46, he says that the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. If you go and fight your battles in your own right and your own strength and your own way and your own cleverness, you're going to get some degree of satisfaction out of that, you know. We call it venting. I just vented, that's all, to make myself feel better. So now that I've ranted back at you, I feel better. You know, that's why we do that sort of stuff. Well, maybe it'll give you some degree of satisfaction in getting people sorted out. But this is never going to send a message out that God is in your neighborhood and in your church. It never will. But when you're just ordinary people, we're just ordinary people. We're just ordinary people acting with integrity and grace, in dependence upon the Lord Almighty, capital L, capital O, capital R, capital D, the name of Jesus Christ. When the victory comes in his name, all glory goes to him, and he is lifted up, and his name is lifted up for all to see him. So we're getting ready to land this message right now. I'm going to ask the band to come up if they would, please. 1 Samuel 17:47. David speaking. when I take this giant out, he says, in the name of the Lord Almighty, then all this assembly shall know that the Lord, all capitals, does not save with sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord's. For all of those giants that I've mentioned this morning, some of you are confronted with at least one of those giants, and some with more, some with more. And in frustration and in impatience, sometimes we want to be like Peter and take out the sword and start cutting an ear or two off. Let's not do that. When, if whatever your giant is, particularly the health one, you know, you're not needing a natural solution. You're not needing natural actions. You are needing supernatural intervention and supernatural solutions. And then number one, God will be made known to all around, and he'll be lifted up and he'll be honored. And number two, he gives you the fruit of the victory to enjoy. I'm believing there's a whole bunch of people here and they're fighting the giant of health issues. I don't believe that just because I'm spiritual, just because you told me that. I want to read you a song this morning. It's from the latest Hillsong album called Let There Be Light, and this song is called As It Is in Heaven. Whether now or then, death is not my end. I know heaven waits for me. Though the road seem long, I'll never walk alone. I've got all I need to sing. I know you love me, I know you found me, I know you saved me, and your grace will never fail me. And while I'm waiting, I'm not waiting, I know heaven lives in me. Should I suffer long, this is not my home, I know heaven waits for me. Though the night is dark, heaven owns my heart, and I've got all I need to sing. So I will sing like I am there in the fearless light of glory, where the darkness cannot find me and your face is all I see. Oh, I'll sing like a man with no sickness in my body. Like no prison walls can hold me, I will sing like I am free. I know you love me. I know you found me. I know you saved me, and your grace will never fail me. And while I'm waiting, I'm not waiting. I know heaven lives in me. I'll sing like a man with no sickness in my body, like no prison walls can hold me. I will sing like I am free. Father in heaven, Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord Almighty, we're looking to you in faith. You know the giants that each individual in this auditorium is dealing with right now. Relational issues, health issues. Father, I'm praying for a breakthrough this morning in this place. I'm praying for a breakthrough. As each person surrenders to you and claims victory in the name of the Lord Almighty, Jesus Christ, help us to see the victory, that the Lord Jesus Christ might be lifted up and honored, and that health will be found in this place, in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's stand, church. We have a song to sing. It's called In the River. Let's get right into the water of Jesus Christ this morning. While we're singing that, you know, some people here are facing health issues. You've got stuff going on. You want to be free of that. Why don't you come down the front this morning as we sing? I'm going to pray for you, and you come down, and we're going to work with you and minister with you in Jesus' name. Let's sing our song. Don't be put off by this. It's a long trip down here. Just, you know, feet like lead. Just make them walk in Jesus' name. Right down here this morning in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord God, for new life, for healing, for health, for well-being. Lord God, may that be everyone in this house, their experience today. And as we go from here, Lord, may we know for sure that we have met this morning with the living God.
And we want to thank you in his name. Father, meet with each person according to their needs this morning, the giants that confront them as they trust you. Thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Just before we move, people, just a couple of things. Got a great service here tonight at 6 o'clock. It's about value. The value God has placed on you, and he values you. Yeah, if you're feeling a bit down and think you're a bit worthless, stop that. Get the value from God. Yeah, that's tonight. And those of you who put your name down for partnership class, that is in here about 10:30-ish, all right? Mark Buckle will be working the crowd for the picnic sake, and go into the cafe, Raisin Toast is for free, get yourself a coffee, get yourself a sausage. If you're brand new here today, would you go into the cafe, and I will see you in there and make myself known to you. Be blessed, have a fantastic day. Look forward to catching up with you soon.